Do you remember the times when we had React conferences or blog posts that would introduce or explore new ideas or features? And then at some point, we would get a new React version that includes those features? Do you remember how it was when hooks were introduced with React version 16.8? Well, it seems like those times are over, at least right now. Because if you take a look at the React releases, you will see that at least at the point of time where I'm recording this, the last stable release has been almost 2 years ago. And it's not like there wouldn't have been any development on React since then, quite the opposite, as I will explore together with you in this State of React 2024 video. Now, I did create a similar video a year ago, and in that State of React 2023 video, I also mentioned that one main shift in the React ecosystem would be towards building full-stack applications with React. And indeed, that is what happened. We now have Next.js version 14, which added stable support for server actions, which essentially was a missing building block to build complete full-stack React applications without any separate API or separate API endpoints. And that was a huge step towards that future where we use React as part of full-stack applications instead of only client-side applications. And that's a great thing. We don't just have Next.js, we for example also have Remix. But at the same time, it's hard to overlook that we have certain features like React server components, which are being used by Next.js and which are stable in Next.js, which are not stable in React and which we can't really use outside of Next.js or other frameworks that implement them. Because it looks like React took a direction where it's primarily meant to be used by frameworks and not standalone. And the new docs that were launched last year kind of proved that, because in there, the recommendation for getting started with React is to get started with a framework like Next.js, instead of just spinning up a Vite-based React project, or even using Create React app as we did in the past. That is not how the React team recommends to start with React. And that's kind of strange, because whilst I think it makes sense for a lot of applications to become full stack again, and whilst I think that it makes sense to think of React as a library that can be used in full stack applications, I'm not sure if I'm a fan of React mostly being a package, a dependency of frameworks like Next.js. And of course, the reality also is different. There are plenty of projects out there that are just using React. So that are just about building a single page application with React, for example. I still would recommend everyone who wants to learn React to start with just React and to then only pick up a framework once they learned those React essentials. Because learning both at the same time, a specific framework and then kind of connected to it React, that can be challenging and can make switching to a different framework extremely difficult. So for all those reasons, I think it still makes a lot of sense to focus on just React, standalone React without a framework, and that's also what you'll see out there in the wild, that there are plenty of projects and jobs that need just React and not Next.js or anything like that. Nonetheless, this seems not to be where the React team is heading with React. As mentioned, the last stable release has been some time ago, and indeed they're now following a different release strategy, which they describe in an official blog post. Their idea essentially is to have canary releases and experimental releases, which are new versions of React that are being released, that contain some stable features, but potentially also some unstable features. And those versions are primarily meant to be used by frameworks that build up on React. And this kind of makes sense because even though React was created by Facebook, and even though it's still part of the Facebook GitHub organization, technically now large chunks of the React team do work at Vercel, which is the company behind Next.js. It seems as if the strategy with React, at least right now, is to focus on its capabilities as a framework dependency instead of as a standalone library. And to some extent, this makes sense, because in that blog post, the React team describes that they're doing it like this so that they can essentially release new stable features that might depend on some unstable features, which they couldn't do if they would release it on the stable branch, where all the features have to be stable. So in order to not be held back, they took this other release strategy. And this kind of makes sense. Still, I feel like React should be usable on its own as well. And of course it is, but those new features, like React server components, are really hard to use without a framework. Which of course makes sense because they need this full stack capability. They need to be used in a full stack application, which React on its own is not about. Nonetheless, maybe that should be the area React should be heading towards, that React itself as a standalone library can be used to build full stack apps or to at least use those features without an extra framework. Because right now the situation is essentially that React is a bit weird. It's a library, theoretically a standalone library, but it seems to be closely tied to Next.js. And that's therefore the state of React in 2024. Still the most popular frontend library, still being used a lot without any frameworks at all, but also a library that's more and more becoming important for full stack development. And when it comes to that, it now seems to be primarily focused on Next.js, and other frameworks like Remix have to kind of struggle to keep up with that new strategy and to implement that strategy correctly into their frameworks. And React on its own is absolutely not becoming a full stack library. Instead, it's now mostly a dependency for such full stack libraries. At least that's how it seems to me. Therefore, of course, working with React is still a great idea. It's popular and so on, and you need to know it if you want to use it with Next.js or another full stack framework. But still, those recent developments are a bit weird. Maybe though, it's just a new normal we have to get used to.